Bună seara, sunt Balázs Barabás și pentru că astăzi este Ziua Națională a Italiei și tocmai pentru că suntem urmașii Romei, o să sărbătorim în stil italian. Adică vom fi veseli, direcți și cu un foarte mare chef de viață. Ambasadorul Italiei la București ne-i prezintă în exclusivitate pe maestrii italieni care dau tonul modei la București sau pe cei care fac cea mai bună mâncare din oraș. Și mai suntem invitați și la o recepție cu vinuri alese și bucate alese pentru fețe alese. Flori, flori pentru toată lumea, flori de dat și de primit. De 2 ani, Ambasada Italiei se implică într-un proiect al Facultății de Agronomie din București. Studenții români învață de la italieni cum pot cultiva flori din cele mai variate specii mediteraneene. Iar producătorii italieni vin să se prezinte și să își arate interesul pentru investiții în România. Toată lumea are numai de câștigat.
Italy is known for many things, but less for flowers. How is your country related to this show today?
Yes, we participate at this floor show Romania, and it's the second time that Italian flowers and plant producers are participating. Italy has a very long tradition in this sector, above all some Italian regions such as Sanremo, for instance, the so-called Riviera dei Fiori. Unfortunately, in the last few years, the sector suffered a very difficult period because of the international competition. As you know, nowadays, Netherlands is the first producer in Europe and one of the first in the world, but of course we suffer also the competition from Eastern Asia and Latin America. At the moment, anyway, the sector is it's important for our economy. We are the second exporter in Romania after Netherlands, and Romania is exporting to Italy, and it's the ninth markets for Italy.
This is the Italian style on how to prepare flower composition.
Mm-hmm. Quindi tendenzialmente l'uso di fiori non possiamo dire di provenienza italiana, ma di provenienza mediterranea. Le piante che sono di completamento di arredo verde provengono tutte dall'Italia.
So the plants are all Italian. Okay.
Questo è il primo ospite,
buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Ma stavate lavorando per voi?
Beh, stiamo facendo una presentazione con il professore qua dell'Università di Agraria, perché noi facciamo micropropagazione, quindi produzione di piante in provetta. Quindi...
Dal suo accento capisco che non viene da Merano.
No, ma dall'Abruzzo.
So these are very specialized plants.
Yes.
You see olives there.
Mm-hmm. And, olive, fichi, agrumi,
also fruit,
frutti di bosco.
Lemon.
Piante da frutto, cioè tutta una serie di...
People for fruit production.
Yes.
Scusi, sono l'ambasciatore.
Molto piacere.
Scusi, ma come in Abruzzo anche siete ormai specialisti di questo tipo?
Noi in Abruzzo rappresentiamo una bella realtà perché siamo specializzati nella riproduzione di giovani piante.
Ah, so they are specialized for... Yes. Mm-hmm. Dice giovani piante? Young
plant.
Young plants, yes.
E vendiamo in molti paesi europei. Che abbiamo un notevole numero di piante, sia come numero che come varietà.
So they export in many European countries.
Perciò
anche
pensa...
in Romania?
No, ecco perché siamo qui per cercare un mercato nuovo
Romania, but they want now to...
che potrebbe essere utile in futuro.
Ok, no, I'm sure that will be very, very interesting and very useful. Bene, auguri.
Un piacere,
auguri.
Grazie.
Arrivederci.
Grazie, auguri.
Grazie. Immagino che queste sono le orchidee, no?
Sì.
Orchids.
Phalaenopsis.
Ma sono sempre tropicali?
No, tropicali no. Resistono bene ai climi anche mediterranei all'esterno.
Mediterranean?
Sì. E queste sono proprio tipiche della fascia mediterranea invece. Sono le piante che vengono più esportate poi dalla zona di produzione.
Yes, these are typical. You can find this even along the beaches in Italy.
Oh, sì.
Resistono anche al freddo. Si sono proprio acclimatate.
Presento l'ambasciatore con
chi è in Germania.
Vuoi dire due parole?
Buongiorno,
sì, siamo ad Albengen, alla
quello diciamo, Riviera dei Fiori.
Riviera dei Fiori. Siamo alla zona, la più grande zona di produzione di piante aromatiche d'Europa. Ne produce circa una ventina di milioni di pezzi.
Siamo qua per aiutarla un po'.
Sì, piante aromatiche sono queste, tu mi ricordi un po' i nomi. Mm-hmm. Allora, rosmarino.
Questo è rosmarino.
Rosmarino.
Questo è rosmarino repens, quello postrato, quello.
Questo è il
questi possono darsi in modo per alimentare.
Sì.
È una pianta ornamentale.
Sì.
Questi sono le. I misti, che sono al limone, sono un po' di gusti, sono molto per fare, si possono usare in cucina, per chi in cucina tendenzialmente si usano per fare i giardini, poi quando arriva l'estate cominciano a fiorire.
Ok, thank you very much for taking us all over, and we hope and we do plan to order an Italian plant to our office to make it much
yes.
prettier.
I hope so, thank you very much.
Despre italieni se spune că sunt întotdeauna bine îmbrăcați. Cei mai mari creatori de modă din toate timpurile vin din Italia. Unul dintre cele mai vechi și mai cunoscute magazine din București vinde haine made in Italy. Aflăm acum secretele farmecului italian.
So we are now in the middle of Bucharest in a store specific for Italy. What exactly is this?
Now we are in Piazza Romana. You said that we are touring for Italy, so Piazza Romana I think is the best place where we can start. Garments suitable for ladies, for men, for youngsters and also for children. They are not on the top ranks as far as the price is concerned, but they can offer very good quality products. They are based in Veneto, in Padova, if I remember well, and they are very famous in Romania because they arrived soon after the revolution.
What kind of garments you prefer? Some casual?
These are very, very good, as we said, for smart, casual, or informal when in summer or in spring. They are very good products for us, for everyone.
Yes. Okay, let's go away. Oh, this is much colorful.
Yes, different colors, as you can see.
It's for teenagers, maybe?
Yes, maybe they are teenagers. And you can see also a special color that resembles the one that is famous in Italy for Missoni. Missoni is a famous brand in Italy, and they are specialized for this kind of colors, stripes and very bright colors.
What do you think of the dressing habits of Romanians versus Italians? How do you see the difference? Is there a difference?
You mean the fashion sector?
Yes, yes. Ordinary people on the streets.
Yes, the Italian are special in this sense. When I go around the world, I immediately realize who is Italian and who is not. How? By the way they are dressing, the way they have their, I don't know, t-shirt, jackets, suits, dresses and so on. We are
It's a matter of combination of clothes?
Yes, combination of clothes, colors, and for men above all, to be smart, even when you are at beach or when you want to, I don't know, to drink a coffee and so on. So this is a special characteristic of our population. Maybe the French are similar in this to the Italians.
So we've seen beautiful Italian dresses, garments in a beautiful house, and now we are moving away to see Italian furniture. How is the stylish Italian furniture?
But this is another characteristic of our made in Italy, you know. In Italy we used to say that we have the 4A, 4A. It is automobile, cars, Ferrari, Fiat and so on. Automotive, machine tools, alimentare, food that we will also visit, and abbigliamento. It means what we saw just here. So our 4A are the focus of the famous made in Italy in the world.
Designerii de mobilă italieni au impus trenduri pe piața internațională. Producția lor de mobilă este una dintre cele mai mari din lume. Ambasadorul Cospito ne-a invitat să ne inspirăm din talentul italienilor pentru decorațiunile interioare și a mers împreună la unul dintre cele mai mari showroom-uri din București. Îl cunoaștem acum pe cel care decorează casele românilor de 18 ani încoace.
We are in a very large furniture shop, also in Bucharest.
The owner Antonio Cantera has been here in Bucharest for the last 18 years. So soon after the revolution, he arrived here in Bucharest. And this is a very nice and important furniture shop here, Italian furniture shop. I want to stress Italian here in Bucharest. You will see this is there are furniture for the living part of an apartment and for the night part of an apartment. There are also kitchen. There are also there is also equipment for bathrooms and so on. So it's a complete shop. So you can furnish an entire apartment here with all the possible furniture and equipments. I want to stress also that most of the production comes from Italy, but also something maybe from Romania, because as you know, your wood, it's very good. So we have also some production here in Romania.
As we can see, the colors are very vivid. It's cyclam and green. Is it typical for Italian homes that use so much vivid colors?
It depends. It depends on what do you like. This is, of course, a modern design, but there is also the possibility to have classical design, sort of similar antique design. Here you see it's all modern, but it's, of course, the style that now is fashionable, so both in Italy and in Romania. And of course, with a modern design, you have all the possible kind of colors.
Let's move a little on. Yes. And here we have
Antonio Cantera, the owner of the shop.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Posso noi dire un poco di vostro
nostra ditta, no?
Sì, sì.
La nostra ditta è sul mercato rumeno da circa 18 anni.
Sì.
Siamo stati pionieri, quindi tra i primi ad arrivare qui in Romania dopo la caduta di Ceaușescu. Operiamo nel campo del mobile, cioè facciamo l'arredamento completo, quindi abbiamo dal settore mobile ma anche il settore di gresse, faianza, parquet, sanitaria, tutto.
Okay. What is the style that Romanians prefer? What is the typical?
Cosa preferiscono i romeni? Okay. Come gusto, diciamo, i rumeni cosa preferiscono?
Ma il rumeno è molto gli piace molto il mobile italiano. Questo, cioè, noi ci troviamo molto bene con loro. Hanno un gusto molto simile al nostro. E quindi il mobile italiano è molto apprezzato, ecco, quindi abbiamo trovato un terreno abbastanza fertile in questo senso.
Questa è una cosa tipica per i rumeni?
Sì, sì, perché loro amano molto il moderno, proprio il moderno più stravagante possibile,
sì.
Quindi va molto bene. O si va sul moderno moderno o si va sul classico, non c'è la via di mezzo. Quindi le novità essenziali, quando esce la novità il rumeno l'accetta molto volentieri, con piacere.
This is plexiglass, no?
Sì, sì.
This is a particular design that in Italy it's
della carta, sì.
Sì, it's very very important. There are many producer in Italy, both in the north but also in Rome and in the south of Italy.
Modă, mobilă elegantă și parcă lipsește ceva. Mâncare, cucina, pizza, lasagna, gătite toate în cel mai pur stil italian. Până la urmă, mâncarea tradițională definește cel mai bine cheful de viață al italienilor. Bucătarul șef al celui mai mare restaurant italian din București a gătit pentru noi o mâncare cum se face la mama lui, acasă la Roma.
For the National Day, we don't have a special special dish, but since it's holiday in Italy, of course we will prepare something special. So it depends on where you live in Italy, where you are in Italy, because every region, every province, every town in Italy is special for food and wine. I read the book once that said that pasta in Italy can be cooked in more than 10,000 different ways. So you have only to choose which one you like. And for the main course in Italy, we use the meat if you live far away from the sea. Otherwise, of course, you use fish, because Italy is a country, as you know, that has a long coast, and fish is also a special content for our recipe. From Genoa to Bari, from Sicily to Trieste, fish is also very, very important in our diet. And of course, the vegetables and the fruit of the season. So now it's late spring, so in Italy we have strawberries, cherries, apples, pears, and also peaches in the southern part of the country.
Okay. Tonight our host Robertos is Bruno. Good evening.
Good evening. Thank you very much.
What will you prepare for us tonight?
Tonight we're going to have a beautiful Italian recipe. It's veal saltimbocca, some prosciutto, salve, puree, and some beautiful sauce, veal sauce with balsamic.
Okay. Is this a traditional Italian dish?
Yes. Very okay. Traditional.
Where do they serve it? Which part of Italy?
From Rome.
Great.
Yes. Go where ahead, I came then. From. Thank you very
yes.
much.
Yes.
So, our recipe is very easy, so everybody can make it at home. We have veal, prosciutto, salve, puree, sauce, some butter, spinach, basil. It's very, very easy. So, we start the recipe taking the veal, clean without the fat. We're gonna put here. We're gonna put some salt, some salve. You can find everywhere. There we go. Then we're gonna put some prosciutto di Parma, two slices. There we go. So our saltimbocca is ready. There is one side raw and one side filled. So puree, it's very easy to make. It's boiled potato with some butter. In this case, we add some truffle oil and some parmesan. So all these three ingredients, they are three here. For the sauce, it's just veal reduction with a little bit of touch of balsamic, so you can find in every shop. So from the ingredients, we proceed to the cooking method. Cooking method is very easy. We're gonna have the pan, there are two. I forgot to say that we're gonna have spinach as well. So it's very easy, hot pan, a touch of oil, and we start to cook our saltimbocca from the side of the prosciutto, so like this. Okay. Same thing we will do for the spinach here. So this side is more hotter. So, this is our plate. The saltimbocca is cooking. Little bit of salt. Little bit of white wine. And the recipe will be ready. The puree is here. very light and tasty. If it became like this, little bit of butter. So, some truffle, some parmesan. We'll go easy that way. So you can see exactly the spinach. The spinach, what is very important, they didn't need to cook too much. So it's just, this is more than enough. A touch of butter and a little bit of parmesan. Some salt. Okay, the meat as well. At that point, a little bit of white wine. We're gonna evaporate the recipe. Okay. And the jus. Okay, so we can dress the recipe. Some puree. In the middle. Some spinach.
Almost ready?
Yeah.
Great, so the whole cooking took about what, 20 minutes?
Yes.
Less than 20 minutes.
No, less than 20 minutes. What is very important is food, it need to be a pleasure. So I don't really think that cooking for a long time, it's really a pleasure every day. So especially in family, we have less time, and the recipe, they need to be tasty, but it's even better if they are quick, because everyday life is no, every day is a different day. So not everybody have a long time to spend. So we're gonna finish the plate. So this is the spinach. Go. This is our saltimbocca. What is important, never overcook. And this is our sauce. Touch of butter. Good. So at that point we go with some garnish and we are ready. So this is our plate.
It looks absolutely artistic.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. We're gonna share together straight away.
Okay.
See you next time.
Lume bună, lume multă și o petrecere la care am regăsit o parte din splendoarea Italiei la București. Ambasadorul Mario Cospito ne-a invitat la reședința domniei sale ca să ne bucurăm de Ziua Națională a Italiei.
What is Italy celebrating on 2nd of June?
We are celebrating our National Day, the foundation of the Italian Republic, 60 years ago, 2 of June of 46, after the Second World War.
Who are you expecting for the tonight's dinner?
I hope that among the hundreds, maybe thousands of guests, there will be persons from the political, economic and cultural society of Romania, Italy, and of course also the International Diplomatic Corps. We have also some guests from Italy. We have a famous guitarist that will play something during the reception. We have also a world football champion, Giancarlo Antonioni, and I'm also expecting top personalities from the Romanian government. I would like also to stress that this evening will not be an evening of celebration only, but we have also to remember what happened recently in Italy, the earthquake in Emilia-Romagna. So we will dedicate this evening to them, to the memory of the victims and of course to the sufferance of the population. That I want to stress also is the Romanian population. We estimate around 50,000 Romanian living in those areas. So this evening we will remember them.
Emisiunea noastră de astăzi se încheie aici. Tanti auguri, Italia și numai bine! Emisiunea noastră se poate revedea pe site-ul digi24.ro/pașaportdiplomatic și, ca de obicei, de pe pagina de Facebook www.facebook.com/pașaportdiplomatic aflați ce pregătim pentru săptămâna viitoare. Vă aștept din nou sâmbătă la aceeași oră, 18:30. La revedere!